Clip. This is 50 Cent.
This is author Jhenea Black.
This is Jim Winston.
Victoria Rao.
This is Tiffany Montgomery, the author of The Millionaire Mistress.
Y'all, it's your boy Terrence Day from BET's 106 O'Clock, a.k.a. Mr. 6 O'Clock. And right now, you're tuned in to blackpodcast.com, and you know how it's going down.
What's going on, everybody? This is Neo, and you are listening to blackpressradio.com. Keep it locked. It's peace and love.
Good afternoon. For BlackPressMagazine.com, I'm DC Livers. Today we have an extra special treat. We are joined with one of the most important filmmakers in the country, David Parks. Mr. Parks, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us.
Well, thank you for asking me to be on your show.
Wow, this is such an honor. Superfly and all the cool things that you've done.
Thank you.
You know, it's just been really great. So let's just talk a little bit about, for the people who are listening, who may be just getting a chance to know you, like some of the students that met you while you were in D.C., just bring us up to speed with, you know, like the quick overview of who you are, what you've done.
Well, I'm an independent filmmaker, and I've been a freelance, I was a freelance photographer in New York City for many years, and I went into filmmaking. And I worked with my father on Shaft as a production person, and I helped produce, co-produce Superfly with my brother Gordon Parks Jr. And I'm now living in Texas doing independent filmmaking, and we're getting ready to shoot a film on the Buffalo Soldiers, and that's taking up much of my time. But now I'm in D.C., and I was for Black Press Week. I was invited to the award ceremony at the Hilton on behalf of the blackpress.org people and you, D.C., and I really enjoyed my talk with the students here from Howard and various institutions at Posh's downtown after the ceremony. So it's been quite an interesting trip.
Yeah, we went everywhere, didn't we?
Yeah, sure did.
We got to meet.
Good to be back in D.C. I used to come in D.C. when I was a child or a teenager, and it's same old D.C. It don't change.
It doesn't change much.
As usual.
Maybe a few elevated security risks, but other than that. But you got a chance to meet New Orleans Mayor Ray Nagin and Congressman Waters.
Miss Waters and Nagin, and it was really an honor and a privilege to meet those folks. And, you know, that continual struggle and trying to keep get New Orleans back on its feet is a continual struggle. And I'm 100% behind what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And very saddened about what happened there.
Yeah.
And hope it gets better.
Well, as a filmmaker, you know, Spike Lee put together that wonderful piece.
Oh, yeah.
When the dams broke.
Oh, yeah.
What did you think about that from a filmmaker?
Oh, I thought it was done excellently. It was an excellent piece. I mean, I saw it myself. I believe it was on HBO. I'm not sure. But he did a fine job. Spike is one of the best filmmakers right now in the industry. And I'm just glad he came along and started to pick up where Gordon Jr. and Gordon Sr. left off, and Melvin Van Peebles. I mean, I'm sure they're all proud of him, and I'm just happy that he did that.
Wow.
I wish I was in the position to do it. I'd be down there with him, profit making.
One of the reasons I wanted you to mention this is because I know that tends to be the thing that people say, well, I can't do it because I don't have the money.
No, you can't afford it, right.
Right.
But there are people out there, Black folks, white folks, et cetera, that have more money they can know what to do with, and instead of gambling it at Vegas, they could gamble it on their history.
Yeah.
Well, makes sense?
Makes a lot of sense to me. I can gamble. Yeah.
But I really appreciate the blackpress.org. You guys, DC Livers, you've done a great job here, and I look forward to doing things in the future with you.
Thank you. I appreciate it. One last question. We would be remiss if we didn't just ask a little bit, just one question about your father and what it was like. He's just such an amazing person.
Oh, yeah. Well, my father passed March 7th, 06, and what we're doing now, I've been on the road trying to help set up some centers across the country that are honoring his work. The Gordon Parks Center for Culture and Diversity in Fort Scott is being built. WSU, Wichita State University, are setting up a center there for his work, and also scholarships for students who are interested in filmmaking, writing, and photography. And hopefully the Cochrane will be promoting some of his work. They have an archive of his. So it's been in the foundation. The Coonhart Parks Foundation is in the works, so you'll have access to his work.
Excellent. That's wonderful.
Yeah.
I really appreciate
there
you.
There in Chappaqua, New York.
What is it again?
Chappaqua,
New York.
Okay. The Coonhart Parks Foundation.
Coonhart Parks. Okay.
Yeah, but, you know, they're looking to, they have control of most of his work, and then if you need his work, they make it available for you to look at and see.
Okay. Thank you so much for taking the time.
Hey, DC, it's been a pleasure.